Hello friends. In this video we'll be covering up a very important aspect in international relations which is coming up with that is known as techplomacy. Now see, this is this techplomacy is a word which is combination of two words, technology plus diplomacy. So techno diplomacy in recent times has been connoted as techplomacy. Now, what is the need of techplomacy? What has been the recent initiatives? How India is lagging in these areas? So we'll be looking in these videos. Okay. Now, see, technology has a huge impact on the conduct of diplomacy since its inception in middle of 20th or 19th century. Say with the coming of telecom revolution. Okay. Now, in present day context, we see technological diplomacy been taken in various fields. Say for example, when we look at the public diplomacy or track to diplomacy, conducting espionage on other states, securing critical infrastructure from against foreign invasion, then there is setting of cross-border data flows or diplomacy. Recently there has been a great havoc regarding Facebook, Google breaching their norms in US and India. Then there has been preventing a militarization of information, artificial intelligence, and in recently we have seen that USA has started its space command, which is highly technologically superior, and surveillance capacity of it would be highly increasing. So in these context changing dimensions, so countries are finding more and more new avenues to adapt to the changed reality. Some recent initiative worth noticing is France has started a digital ambassador. Denmark has started techplomacy branches with in Beijing, in Silicon Valley and Copenhagen to engage with technological giants like Google, Facebook, social media sites, then Alibaba, etc. Next, we see what changes that diplomacy had to face in the changed communicative or communication revolution. See, earlier, due to lack of communication or daily flow of information, ambassador used to take decision on his own behalf without any whatsoever reliance on the state or the home country. Now with the change, with the coming of communication revolution, the aristocratic diplomat was changed to professional diplomat, where home countries were continuously monitoring their working. Next, negotiation increased primarily, which initially was primarily based on, say, maintaining peace and treaty. Now there was a various broad spectrum including climate change and nuclear deals. Okay, in present context, that technologically the technology has been improvising itself in digital and genetic front, which are capable of bringing changes in economy, politic, society, culture, international relation at a substantive level. So this is the way, is the bedrock or the context in which we are talking about techplomacy has grown in its importance. Then we need to understand that private sector, previously private sector, or say in India, private sector had always been on the back front. However, now in recent or say contemporary times, private sector has amassed lot of information resources as well as cutting edge level bureaucracy, and is helping in both country management as well as our international relation management. So bringing that into can be an active way, bringing private sector into our folds would be an active way of bringing in techplomacy. Then so we need to understand that challenges and opportunities presented by the unfolding technological revolution are too complex and broad to be left to individual departments. So say it should not be key that managing technology should be given to only, say, Ministry of External Affairs. What we need is the whole government approach led by PMO on techplomacy, and this is where we can, techplomacy can become a daily routine.